There's not really a day where I don't look at it.
It's fun to watch.
I use it pretty much all the time.
It's just entertaining.
I enjoy doing the videos on myself.
In Australia, we're obsessed. More than 7 million users spending on average 52 minutes a day watching cat clips, choreographed dances and absurd challenges.
You just keep scrolling and scrolling and scrolling. All of a sudden, like 2 hours has passed and it's just...
It's very addictive.
But while we're watching TikTok, it's watching us.
It is a great hoovering up of people's personal data.
In the new report, Aussie cybersecurity firm Internet 2.0 has revealed TikTok mines excess amounts of personal info on iPhones and especially Android phones, including hourly location checks, contact lists, calendars, almost complete access to the contents of your phone while you're scrolling the app. And none of this info is necessary for TikTok to run.
This leads us to believe that the only reason this information is being gathered is for data harvesting.
The permission layer that the phone was requesting was significantly more than what they had said they were doing publicly.
TikTok is owned by the Chinese company ByteDance, and for years it's assured users all data is stored in the US and not accessible in China.
We do not share information with the Chinese government.
In response to the new report, TikTok says,
"The TikTok app is not unique in the amount of information it collects. We collect information that users choose to provide to us and information that helps the app function, operate securely and improve the user experience."
And that
it is categorically untrue to imply there is communication with China.
We're not entirely clear as to what they're sending to China, but under close examination by every cybersecurity product we threw at it, every single time we saw it connecting to servers in China.
There is likely Australian citizen data being held in China, and what we know is that the Chinese Communist Party, by law, can walk into any organisation that's on Chinese soil and access that data. The risk is also about human rights and personal safety. You might have political views that in the future the Chinese government doesn't like, and you've exposed potentially that data online, and you continue to have that data held by a company and in a country where you really don't understand the processes and the rules for its protection.
But while calls grow for governments to ban TikTok, some users just don't seem too fussed.
At this stage, it wouldn't stop me from using it, I don't think.
Everyone kind of, at the moment, has access to everything, so in fact, you can't get away from it.
I'm not too concerned because I don't have that much to hide from the Chinese government.
I mean, I was watching a video of poodles in tracksuits last night thinking, this is worth losing my data for. I really believe this.
You deleted your app today.
I did. Well, I'm not really on. I've had downloaded to see what all the fuss was about a little while ago, but I don't really use it. So I thought, why have I got it on my phone? Why take the risk? So I did delete it today. I mean, in fact, you're one of the big TikTok users in the world, Carrie. When you posted your TikTok video, your famous TikTok, did you realise that all your data has been stolen?
Used to be bored in lockdown. Okay. I haven't been on it for a few years, Pete.
No, but when you're doing that, your data was being stolen. You do know that.
And my child in the background.
Yeah, your child. You really ran over your child.